My name is Katherine, and I am a citizen of the Confederated Tribes of Umatilla in Oregon. I've lived here my whole life, and these are the lands of my ancestors. Our culture and identity as people are tied to the land. Picking berries, catching salmon, digging roots. Climate change won't only kill off all of these species, but also our entire identity as Indigenous people. We come from hunter-gatherer tribes, so this doesn't only impact me, but our entire community. Since I was little, my family and I would always go up into the mountains to pick huckleberries, which are a part of our traditional first foods. Our communities are connected through those foods because those are the foods that have sustained us through hard times, and those are the foods that have taken care of us through years of colonization and genocide. Like, we had those foods to rely on. They continue to sustain us and nourish our bodies and our souls and our spirits. Picking huckleberries with my family is like one of the things that I am most fond of. There's all these baskets, and I love looking at the baskets that my grandmother gave us that still have the huckleberry stains in them. That is such a core piece of how I connect with my Indigenous culture, is through these foods. It's something that I need to fight for to make sure that I did all I could do to save something that I care about. When Standing Rock happened, it inspired me to start taking action and to really think about what skills I have to contribute to this larger climate movement. I realized that I wanted to commit my work and life to stopping corporations and governments from harming our tribal nations. At the Women's Earth and Climate Action Network, I act as the communications coordinator, where I have the opportunity to shift the narrative around climate change and ensure that women's voices are heard. Women are impacted first and worst by climate change, yet we're the backbones of our communities. It's important to uplift women's voices and the amazing work that they do within the climate movement. And for me, the women in my family are powerful. They inspire me every day to take hold of my own responsibility and to take hold of my own power and to share that and to bring my voice up. It hurts to read every single day about the species that are being lost, about the communities that can't drink their water anymore, about pipelines that are going through Indigenous lands without consent, and about women that are being harmed through all of this. And so to remind myself of the ancestors who have fought so hard for me to exist in the first place, their everyday resilience is what inspires me to keep doing climate work. I realize that there is a specific voice that I bring in terms of being young and Indigenous that come together to really advocate for our rights as Indigenous people, as well as our rights as young people to have a future. These lands have been here longer than humans have. These crevices, these canyons, these mountains have existed forever, and they're worth fighting for. They need a voice, and to share my voice on behalf of the mountains and the forests and the rivers is an honor and a privilege.